Per usual, everything on this channel is for educational purposes only and is not intended as financial advice. In the last video here of the Kraken Pro tutorial series sponsored by Kraken, let's talk about some fun stuff. Let's talk about conditional orders. Let's talk about advanced order types. So at this point, just to recap, you've got your balance, you've deposited ETH, Bitcoin, USD, whatever it is, fiat, crypto, through a payment processor, and we're good to go on that end. Let's say we're waiting for, you know, USDT, what have you. We're sending it on the right network. We're not screwing that one up, because if you do, those funds potentially can get lost. So always make sure you're sending coins to and from the direct selected network you have there. Super, super important. So we learned about limit and market orders in the last video. Limit orders are orders you place on the order book itself. Market orders just take whatever price is available at the current time and buys or sells. Now, if you're trying to get a large fill on an order, it's usually a bad idea to use a market order. There'll be lots of slippage there, potentially, depending on the market. And if you want, you can use the depth chart to see the percentages and the amounts of coin on the order book, and we can zoom in and out here. I personally don't use this too often, but it can be helpful if you're noticing that, wow, price isn't really moving beyond 1997, 1999. Why is that? You know, this is indicating there's a large order here at this level, 1999.86. And to select between limit and market, we use the dropdown here. It's also the simple market order form we can use beyond that. And we can also see the order book directly, right? If we want to see market depth. And you can change the grouping here based on dollar amounts, on price, and you can see again, what is the depth? What does the buy and sell picture look like? Let's say you're, you know, waiting on a breakout trade, you're waiting for a level, and you know, you're looking at how deep is the book. This can be a dangerous game. I generally avoid looking at market depth, the order book, right? This stuff can move around dramatically at any given moment on any exchange, right? So just keep that in mind. One other useful and slick thing you'll notice about the order book is if we have an order, let's say we have an order at 1995, it's a sell, it's a limit. We want to sell some ETH up there. You see it populate on the chart. Now, let's say we notice price is rising or falling towards our order, and we want to remove that quickly from the order book itself. You can either exit out here on the chart, cancel order. You can exit out here on the open orders section, or directly on the order book itself. You can exit out one click and it's off the book. One other quick note about fees for Kraken. You can click your fee schedule in the box here. Your fees will be based on your 30-day rolling volume. It's always beneficial to use limit orders, that maker fee instead of a taker fee. But from time to time, as we all know, market orders can be beneficial. One other option you can select here to always make sure that your limit orders are limit orders and never market orders is this post only option, and that'll always make sure it's added to the order book. It may throw you a notification, you know, if we're trying to add something below the order book. Let's see, 1960 here. Let's sell some ETH. You can see that the order was canceled because we have post only selected. So that'll protect you from any sort of accidents or fat finger mistakes there. In the more options section below here, you can also see fees, whether or not it's a conditional order, and then other, you know, more advanced order types here. And Kraken is also implementing additional advanced order types like icebergs as time goes on here. One thing I always get a question about is stop losses. You know, do I put them on the book? Do I use stop losses at all? In the Kraken UI here, you can use the stop loss order type. Again, you want to make sure you're on the right market type here for a margin, futures, or spot, if that is available in your jurisdiction. Let's say we want a stop loss. If price gets below, based on the chart, we'll say 1615, okay? 1615. That's 18% below, right? And let's say you want a more rigorous stop, something like 10% or 15%, whatever your stop loss tolerance, loss tolerance may be. From there, we can select the quantity of ETH. Let's say we want to have a sell trigger there at 1614 USD with $500 worth of ETH. We'll click that button here, and you'll see the sell stop loss pop up. It'll confirm, and it won't show up in your open orders. It'll show up in the conditional orders section. And on that order form, you'll also probably notice that under the More Options tab, this changed slightly on the based on the options selected. So if I wanted to use a stop loss or a trailing stop loss, that's one way to do it. And let's say I just want to hold this position until it's below X level, I could do that. Something else we could do here, instead of effectively what would be a stop loss market order, could do a stop loss limit order. And this gets even more advanced. We can, let's say we want to sell whatever quantity of ETH. We want the trigger to be, let's say, 1650. And we want to put the limit order at 1655. And again, you'll see that on the chart, it'll confirm. You'll see that in the conditional orders section here. And that way, depending on our size, we can separate our orders. We can separate our stop losses. If we want different types of strategies, we can use those advanced order types. Now, the same is also true on take profit limit. Let's say we have a range in mind here on ETH. For example, this is what I think is an ascending triangle. We've applied our TA. We've applied our Fibonacci extensions. We want to start to sell based on, you know, X level. Let's say it's 2785. Let's say we want to sell. Use a take profit here. We want the trigger to be 2785. We want the limit order to be 3100. And we want to sell some quantity of ETH here. You'll notice as these boxes are selected, they won't change. But if we want the distance, for example, percentage wise on any of these orders, we can also keep those fixed if we wanted to. So let's say we wanted our trigger again at 2785. We want it to be a limit order, sell this quantity of ETH. And again, you'll see it on the chart here. It'll confirm. You'll see it in conditional orders. Now, one place you could get tripped up here is if you've got a bunch of market orders or a bunch of limit orders here, and you're getting errors on the quantities, or you want to have a stop loss on a greater amount, or you want to have a take profit on a greater amount. You have to make sure that that amount of ETH or that amount of coin isn't already in some sort of order somewhere. So we could always cancel out the order here. You'll see it disappear from the chart. You get the confirmation there. And then that's then available right on this side of things for the conditional order. And again, let's say we wanted to sell 100% of it, conditional order. Let's say we want some, you know, blow off top type of trigger and limit. Let's say we want the trigger to be 3150. Want the limit to be, I don't know, 3333. And we want to get rid of all of our ETH at that level. Sell your ETH, and again, you get that confirmation. It shows up in conditional orders, and you're all set. You're ready to go. You don't need to pay attention to it. You don't need to constantly babysit it. It's ready to go. The actions are ready to be taken. And if you wanted to move any of these values, you can click and drag directly on the chart here and change all those values independently if you wanted to and move things around. Also, I'll say just down here, if you wanted to separate out, you know, your open orders from your conditional orders, you can click and drag and move this around. It's all completely modular, completely up to you and how you want this to look. So that's all I have for this one. I hope these videos were helpful. I hope they make you a better trader, make you understand the new and improved Kraken UI better. Like, dislike, comment, share, subscribe, and happy trading.